Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive at London and news from Anglo Pacific this morning to buy a portfolio of copper and nickel royalties from South 32. We're going to go through all of the details and that and much more as well with Mark Bishop Livage. So a warm welcome to you, Mark.
Good morning, Katie.
So let's talk now because you have announced this exciting acquisition, and this is of an entire portfolio of royalty and streaming investments today. Maybe tell us more about the acquisition itself and how the group is financing it as well, importantly.
I would be absolutely delighted to do so, Katie. I mean, ultimately, this transaction is straight down the fairway in terms of our stated strategy. It reinforces our position as the leading future-facing metals royalty and streaming company. And we're thrilled to get this one into our portfolio. We're acquiring a portfolio of four royalties, which is fantastic because it provides immediate growth on a scale that would require four separate transactions. But there are really two key royalties in this transaction. The first is a royalty over the West Musgrave's nickel and copper project that's located in Australia. And the second relates to a royalty over the Santo Domingo project owned by Capstone Copper now, and located in Chile. I mean, you know, these are really, in the terms of the two key assets, these are really well-established operators, tier one jurisdictions, expected to be producing within the first quartile on the global cost curves, just really ticking all the boxes. In terms of your second question on how we're financing it, we're offering as consideration to South 32 a 17% pro forma stake in the enlarged share capital of the business and approximately $48 million at close. So you can see that we've really endeavored to structure this transaction on the upfront payment to reduce the amount of cash going out day one. And then beyond that, we have six quarterly payments of approximately slightly less than $10 million for a total of 55. So what we're doing, and it's consistent with what we've done in the past 9 years here, is recycle coal cash flows effectively into, in this instance, copper and nickel transactions.
All right, and maybe tell us how this is in line with your focus on future-facing commodities and how the commodity mix of Anglo's portfolio will look like post this acquisition.
Our strategy has clearly been to develop a portfolio of royalties over commodities and projects that ultimately are required to deliver us a more sustainable future. And now, post-transaction, copper, cobalt, nickel, these commodities are going to form the core of our portfolio, and to close will be approximately 70% of our assets. So we're really continuing on our journey away from coal and our heritage of coal to reposition this portfolio to commodities that are absolutely vital and crucial for the electrification and decarbonization of energy. And if we ignore Kestrel, which is our coal asset, which is now expected to run off in 2026, based on all the acquisitions we've done in the last 9 years, we have a line of sight on a sustainable revenue profile of $100 million, which is quite the accomplishment considering that, you know, 9 years ago, our business was one asset and coal.
All right. And as you've just pointed out there, the portfolio, it's got significant exposure to both copper and nickel. You've mentioned that the EV market as well and the future of that. Maybe tell us why these commodities in particular have strong fundamentals.
I think there's to really distill it down, and there are many reasons, but to distill it down to two points. So first, the past decade has seen historically exceptionally low levels of investment into new supply. So we're entering into the next decade or two with historically very few projects in the pipeline to contribute to new supply. And the mining sector by definition is very capital intensive, and bringing new supply online is not a matter of flicking a switch. It can take decades or year or multiple decades even. So that's the first part. Second, the energy transition is expected to require just huge amounts of copper and nickel. On the copper side, primarily into energy grids, energy transmission, energy storage. And second, on the nickel side, on the lithium ion battery front. I mean, over the next 20 years, folks are forecasting almost three times more nickel demand, which is a level of demand that's arguably almost unprecedented, that we even struggle to wrap our head around in terms of how that's actually achievable. And it's a major challenge, but that for us is the opportunity. And therefore, in the context of our portfolio, we see absolutely phenomenal and enormous commodity price upside potential over the life of these royalties.
All right, let's maybe move away from the opportunity and the commodity exposure. What will the acquisition, what will it mean for Anglo Pacific's earnings? And what are the advantages of buying assets in the development stage?
So in terms of that first question, what we've looked to do is to structure this transaction to allow us to take what are one-off and non-repeatable, almost record levels of cash flow from our Kestrel royalty, which as I mentioned earlier, is going to run off, and effectively recycle that capital as best we can into paying for these assets. So what does that do for us? Well, at transaction close, it ensures that we have a strong balance sheet and ensures that for in the medium term and long term, based on our current platform of income producing assets, the dividend at 7p is very well covered. In the current market, we think there are a lot of interesting, exciting opportunities to keep adding and to keep growing our portfolio. So we think in terms of capital allocation at this time anyways, a 7p dividend with the balance going towards funding growth from an earnings perspective is the right thing to do, but that can be revisited in a year or two as necessary, depending on where we are in the commodity cycle.
All right, let's maybe go into detail now on the assets a bit more. Let's maybe talk about the mine life of the assets and their upside to the stated resource and the production figures as well.
So in terms of the asset themselves, you know, West Musgrave's, starting with that asset, has a 26-year mine life. The asset is very well positioned on the industry cost curve. Very strong operator or owner in OZ Minerals. And important to note that OZ Minerals has a really strong track record of bringing projects into production. And therefore, we think that significantly enhances, you know, the value of these royalties, but the likelihood that these royalties will be generating cash flow in the future. On the Capstone side, Santo Domingo is a primarily copper project located in Chile. Again, well located on the cost curve. Our royalty doesn't cover the entire mine plan that's envisaged at the Santo Domingo operation, but our royalty is expected to cover the first 6 to 7 years roughly of production. And on that basis, cover the most highest grades of copper in the mine plan, which therefore means that, you know, in any mining schedule, it's pretty common for these high grade portions to be mined first. And then the royalty we expect and estimate to come back into production sometimes around year 14 for the final 4 years of the current reserve-based mine life. That being said, these assets really do tick the box in terms of giving us upside potential, both in terms of production and life of mine extension.
All right. And finally, what are the next steps for the deal? And is there potential for the deal to be built on further in the future?
So in terms of the deal closing itself, we anticipate a fairly short period to close. There are no conditions, so it's all fairly customary mechanical completion steps. South 32, as I mentioned earlier, has taken an enlarged group share capital, approximately 16.9% stake in the business. That is, we think, a really strong vote of confidence in terms of our ability to continue to grow the business in a value accretive way, in terms of our, you know, a vote of confidence in our track record and a strong signal of our partnership. We really enjoyed working with the team at South 32 on this transaction. And South 32 do have a portfolio of other base metals and other royalties that in the future we can certainly look to explore acquiring. Ultimately, there's going to be a really strong strategic rationale for South 32 to continue and extend our partnership into the future. More broadly, looking at what we'll do next, we've seen commodity prices pull back pretty significantly. We really like this transaction simply because we're able to price it at levels well below those we've seen in the market for the past 12 to 18 months on spot basis. but spot prices have come down pretty substantially. And so next, we think while we may announce a relatively small development stage royalty, we think the next big transaction for this group would be in relation to a producing asset.
All right, we'll come back and tell us more when you can. Thank you very much indeed. Mark there from Anglo Pacific here on Proactive.